Leah here from Leah4sci.com, and in this video, I will show you how to analyze the effects of leaving groups in SN1, SN2, E1, and E2 reactions. But first, what is a leaving group? A leaving group, as the name implies, is the atom or molecule that leaves, either by getting eliminated or kicked out in a substitution and elimination reaction. In a substitution reaction, when you react a carbon chain containing a leaving group with a nucleophile, your product is going to have the carbon chain with a nucleophile attached where the leaving group used to be, and the leaving group floating around in solution. In an elimination reaction, your carbon containing the leaving group is going to react with a base, but instead of the base replacing the leaving group, your leaving group as well as your beta hydrogen will be gone, and there will be a pi bond where those two atoms used to be. As you're analyzing the effect of a leaving group on a reaction, don't forget that you'll also have to look at the following: the alkyl chain, the attacking molecule, and the solvent in determining between substitution and elimination, and in determining between the one type, meaning SN1, E1, or the two type, SN2 or E2 reactions. Because it is these factors that will usually determine between substitution and elimination, but the leaving group will help us determine between the one type and the two type, and also the speed of the reaction. Let's analyze the one type reaction, given that SN1 and E1 start out the same way, where the leaving group grabs a lone pair of electrons that connected to the carbon chain and disappears off of the molecule. This leaves you with a carbon chain that has a positive charge and a leaving group that has the extra lone pair of electrons. Assuming all factors allow for the carbocation to form, the speed of this reaction will be determined by the leaving group's willingness to leave. In a two-type reaction, the leaving group is kicked out, so we don't analyze it as closely because it's typically not given a choice. Picture this scenario. You're watching TV with your younger sibling, and you're sitting in your favorite chair. You get up to grab a cup of water, and your sibling steals your chair. Now, I don't know about you, but if I see my younger sister sitting in my chair, I kick her out. I'm bigger, I'm stronger, and that's my chair. In other words, when I left, I was not happy to be gone, and because I wanted to come back, that would make me a bad leaving group. My younger sister, on the other hand, didn't have a choice. Because I kicked her out, it didn't matter if she was a good leaving group or not, because I was stronger and took that choice away. In other words, when you analyze the ability of a leaving group, don't look so much at the leaving group's willingness to leave, as much as the ability of the leaving group to stay gone. As a rule of thumb for leaving groups, a good leaving group is a weak base. In other words, it's the conjugate base of a strong acid. But often, you're not given a pKa table to determine the acid strength, and so you have to understand how to actually analyze the atoms or group of atoms to determine if your reaction will proceed quickly, slowly, or not at all. So how do you know if a leaving group is happy to stay gone? Let's use a real example and analyze what happens to the charge of that leaving group. We'll start with the molecule 2-bromobutane, where in this case, bromine is the leaving group. If we do a quick formal charge on bromine, it should have 7 valence electrons, and it does have 7 electrons directly attached, giving it a formal charge of 0. As a leaving group, bromine grabs the 2 red electrons, breaking the bond between bromine and carbon, and takes it as it leaves the carbon chain. In addition to the carbocation that is formed, we now also have a bromine with a full octet with its 3 initial lone pairs of electrons plus those 2 red electrons that it took from the bond to carbon. A quick formal charge calculation shows me that bromine should have had 7 valence electrons. 7 minus 8 gives me negative 1, and so I have a negative charge on bromine. Now the question you have to ask yourself is, bromine capable of holding that negative charge? When it comes to the ability of an atom to hold the charge, size matters. Look at the trend of the halogens on the periodic table. You'll see that we have fluorine, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine, telling me that fluorine is the smallest and iodine is the largest. If I place a negative charge on iodine or iodide, the negative charge will be well distributed over the large atom, making it more capable of holding that charge and therefore more stable. Compare this to a negative chlorine or chloride. The atom is smaller, the charge is less distributed or more concentrated, making this a little bit more reactive and therefore a little bit less stable. While chlorine is considered an okay leaving group, iodine is considered a very good leaving group because it can hold that negative charge better. Now let's take a look at oxygen as a leaving group. Oxygen, which shows up on the second period, is a rather small and highly electronegative atom. When oxygen grabs the two bonding electrons to break away from the carbon, once again we wind up with a carbocation and a negative oxygen in solution. Unlike the halogens, oxygen, which is so small, highly electronegative with concentrated charge, is considered to be a very strong base or strong nucleophile, and therefore, if you manage to kick it out, it won't stay gone, but instead will use its negative electrons to attack right back and reverse the reaction. But oxygen isn't always a terrible leaving group. The reason OH- was not happy leaving is because the oxygen was left carrying that entire burden of charge. However, if you can have an oxygen as a leaving group that shares the charge with another atom, it'll be a lot happier, a lot more stable, and therefore less likely to come back and attack. Say I have another molecule that has oxygen as a leaving group, but this oxygen is attached to a carbonyl and then a CH3. You'll recognize that this is an acetate portion, meaning the conjugate base of acetic acid, which is a decent acid. And when the bond between carbon and oxygen breaks, it's not only oxygen that is left carrying the charge. Let's analyze just the leaving group. The negative charge sits on the oxygen atom, but that oxygen is bound to a partially positive carbonyl carbon bound to a partially negative carbonyl oxygen. And so this negative oxygen can use its electrons to attack towards the carbonyl position, breaking the pi bond between carbon and the second oxygen. To show the alternate resonance form, we start with the skeleton, and now let's see what happened with the electrons. We have the black pair of electrons that formed a carbonyl between the left oxygen and carbon, and we'll show these pi electrons as being purple, breaking onto the oxygen. As you can see, the negative charge moved onto the other oxygen, but in reality, it's constantly going back and forth. Therefore, we don't have one oxygen holding a negative charge, but instead, we have two oxygens sharing that negative charge. Since half a negative charge is less of a burden than a full charge, this is a stable molecule and therefore a good leaving group. But what do you do when you really have to kick out your OH? Well, you bribe it, of course. Be sure to join me in the next video, 2 of 2 of the leaving group series, where I show you how to bribe this OH group using either an acid catalyst or a tosyl group.
Are you struggling with organic chemistry? Are you looking for information to guide you through the course and help you succeed? If so, download my ebook, 10 Secrets to Acing Organic Chemistry, using the link below, or visit leah4sci.com/orgosecrets. That's O-R-G-O secrets. For information regarding online tutoring, visit leah4sci.com/orgotutor. That's O-R-G-O tutor. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and even share it with a friend or two. If you have any questions regarding this video, leave a comment below or contact me through my Facebook page at facebook.com/leah4sci. There will be many related videos posted over the course of the semester, so go ahead and click the subscribe button to ensure that you don't miss out.